Hi everybody, welcome back to the Shonen Knife Bass Project. Today for song number 22, we're doing Get the Wow. This song is an homage to the girl groups of the 1960s. I played the little sampling at the beginning to illustrate this point. This was the music that was constantly playing in my house when I was growing up. If you look around YouTube, you'll find many Japanese bands who mimic the various styles of music from the past. Some of these bands are quite good, but very few of them go beyond just the look and the sound, as if simply doing that was enough. Shonen Knife always put their own spin on whatever genre they took on. They really pioneered this retro idea, and not surprisingly, they did it the best. There are several versions of this song, the Let's Knife version being the most notable. Today we're looking at the version from the John Peel sessions. To those of us who don't know, John Peel was a legendary English DJ, record producer, and journalist. Sadly, he died in 2004. On his radio show, he invited new and exciting bands to perform. These performances were known as the Peel Sessions. Shonen Knife did two of the Peel Sessions in 1992, and they've given us some really great music. All of this music, by the way, has been uploaded to YouTube by a fellow YouTuber by the name of L Jerk Diamondheart, and I'm showing his link at the bottom here. You can click on it and get there. There's some really good stuff there. You should check it out. Okay, the bass line bounces around quite a lot in the way that Michie frequently favored. And she even steps forward during the guitar break and does a little duet with Naoko. This is really good stuff. Okay, let's hear the song. Okay, what about those lyrics? Many Shonen Knife fans have called this the only sexually suggestive song that the group ever did. And yeah, I think that's right. I do not think the lyrics are as explicit as we're making them out to be, however. We in the West, with our endless cynicism, try to make everything sexual. We are simply reading way too much into what Naoko is giving us. The song is certainly about a girl who's ready to enter into a physical relationship with her partner. This song is all about that rush of excitement that happens when you find the right person and you decide to share that experience with them. But that's all it's about. Take, for example, the first set of lyrics. When you open my little box, wow, big surprise from me to you, wow. I think Naoko would be pretty surprised, maybe shocked, to know that most of us are thinking that the little box is a vagina. And let's face it, almost all of us are thinking that. Well, I don't think so. I think it's a present, or a gift, if you will, of a physical relationship that this girl is giving to her lover. and this change in the relationship is the big surprise referred to in the next line. If viewed the other way, honestly, what's the surprise? I'm pretty sure that most of us have never been surprised in this situation. The next set of lyrics won't work either if you view it in this cynical way. Come on now, we're gonna have a good party. Hey, let's eat some honey pie, baby. I won't state the obvious, but the girl in the song is talking about them enjoying the sweetness of the physical experience. That's all. This may very well be a subtle translation problem that makes all this sound so sexual, or it may be that we've reached a point where we just can't see the beautiful innocence anymore in a very basic human emotion. I don't know. I suppose many of you will disagree with me, and the only proof that I can offer is this. In over 250 other songs, Naoko or Michie never made any reference to this type of thing. Never. And I think it's really unlikely that they're doing so here. Okay, see you next time. Since you're already here, put away something bad. Since you're already here, think just happy things.